Bloodborne. Bloodborne is the best FromSoft game. I still consider Bloodborne to be the best. Bloodborne definitely is. Three prayers and two quiets.
I don't get it.
The thing that all of these comments have in common is that they are all from the same video, and that video had nothing to do with Bloodborne. And it is amazing to me that everyone agrees on loving this game so much. I mean, these two comments love and hate Sekiro, and they're on the same video, which was actually about Sekiro. But Bloodborne seems to be one of those things that everybody just loves, like if FromSoftware made Beyonce. I already knew that Bloodborne was a good time. I have the Platinum and I almost finished the DLC, and if I can learn to tune out the screams of an angry orphan fetus, I may go back and try again one day. But I hadn't played it in a while, and I wanted to try and work out why everybody loves this game so much. So join me today, as we look past the obvious and try and work out exactly what is the big deal with Bloodborne. Before I became a Souls addict, there were two guys in my office who basically bullied me into trying Bloodborne. They were hardcore, man. I was all, do I really gotta try this game? And they were all, bro, if I ever have kids, I'm gonna call them all Bloodborne. Anyway, fast forward to today, and we are a happy Souls junkie family. So I asked them, hey, remember when you told me I had to try Bloodborne and it was super important to you?
Perhaps.
Well, I was just wondering, what is it exactly that makes you love that game so much? I don't know what I expected from them, but what I got was just...
maddeningly unhelpful.
The Lovecraft aesthetic. And you get a gun.
Maddeningly unhelpful.
Putting aside the promising careers they both clearly missed out on, in the fields of marketing and answering a f***ing question, I use this as a starting point. Oh, and obviously, I played a chunk of the game again. Okay, so, I kinda knew what people meant by Lovecraft and Eldritch and such. It makes perfect sense to set all of this in a Victorian England-style setting. You've got the Industrial Revolution, horrific medical experiments, Jack the Ripper. Yeah, I'm never gonna understand why this era gets romanticized so much. I mean, apart from the Muppets Christmas Carol, of course.
Hello, London!
So we're gonna put a spoiler warning for this almost 10-year-old game right here, so we can talk about the story. Yeah, I'm not doing that. Let's just go with what the dude at the start tells you.
Don't think too hard about all of this. Just go out and kill a few beasts.
It gets a lot crazier than this, but it doesn't really matter. Some people love the story, but I think most people are just here for all the crazy monster designs, and the gothic architecture, and all the mysterious things going on. God damn it, I've basically just described the aesthetic. Before I had any idea what Bloodborne was, I saw it on a shelf one day, and I saw the dude holding the gun, and even though I had no interest in those Dark Souls games at the time, even I had to admit,
this is the coolest thing I have ever seen.
On the face of it though, the guns really suck. They barely do any damage, unless you're talking about the big old cannon. Or Thor's banister. Or the watering can filled with fire. But these guys tend to come later on, and you don't always have a lot of ammo to spare. FromSoftware want you to use that gun for parrying, and even though they spell it out for you, and they take away your shield, except for when they do give you a shield but also tell you not to use it, and they even put this guy right at the start to force you to learn how to gun parry, because this guy is so much bullshit unless you do. Nobody figured this out. Not f***ing one of us, until we saw someone else do it. Then it was amazing. This. this right here is where I really started to buy into this game. Trick weaponry, ladies and gentlemen. Like a sword that becomes two swords, and a drill that becomes a slightly different drill, and a wheel that becomes two wheels with ghost jam between them, and a sword that becomes a hammer, and a sword that somehow becomes more dangerous when you put it away. Oh, and my absolute favorite, a lightsaber. Somewhere between trying out all these really cool weapons and blocking huge bad guys with guns, it hit me. Bloodborne is the Matrix.
I know Kung Fu. Welcome to the real.
Your hunter has all the crazy swordsman samurai moves, and they know all the gunfu, and they wear long coats, and you can even have default sunglasses when you make your character. You can chain dodge around the monsters instead of fat rolling away. When you get hurt, you can inject yourself and beat your health back out of the enemy that took it. Instead of, you know, stopping for a drink. So your hunter is somewhere between Neo and the Lord of the Dance. So how can Bloodborne possibly be a hard game? Well, the bad guys love to have tantrums at you. And they also travel in packs. You also have to listen to them, and this is where I get the most frustrated because my ears can only take so much growling. I f***ing hate these crows. Like always though, these guys have their patterns and figuring them out is really fun. Gun parrying all the big boys never gets old, but I'm always gonna have mixed feelings when I lose my sleeve inside Wilbur. Also, you've got the bosses, and these guys are like really fast, really huge, really vicious monsters that never stop screaming and throwing their tantrums at you. Now, Father Gascoigne though, this guy got my respect. He skill checks you so hard, and you have to use everything you have learned to get past him. Coming back to this guy was tough. But when I got there, it was an amazing feeling. Before I start to wrap up, I really gotta do the Bloodborne catwalk, because this was the moment right here, guys, when fashion souls became a thing. Bloodborne has a rich setting and a deep story. It has fast and rewarding gameplay. It has very cool mechanics and tons of weapon variety. Everything from the way you move to the way you heal is designed to keep it all moving really fast. Bloodborne has truly disgusting creatures and creepy horror stylings. Bloodborne is the tough but fair and rewarding From Software philosophy, all wrapped up in a ton of things that so many people love to see. And I think this is the core of why everybody loves it so much.